loves public speaking, so I knew she would get back down. But let me pray before we get started this morning.
Dear Lord, we thank you so much for your love. Lord, that we get to look in your word and seeing how you show up and how your characteristics have shown up in our moms. Lord, that you have given moms a superpower, and it's from you alone. Lord, we just thank you for your grace and for your love that you give us, and the compassion that you give us to love and have compassion on others, Lord. So, Lord, we just thank you for your grace and your goodness. Amen. So it's so good to see you all this morning. So this morning is going to look a little different. You're probably used to going to Book of Luke, and we're just going through that. But this morning, I want us to kind of look through our moms and seeing how the Lord has working through our moms. Not only that, as I was working through this, man, I was so blessed by seeing how the Lord, it's the Lord's characteristics. It's His characteristics that are showing through godly women through our communities. In God's word, we see it, and I see it in the moms and the grandmas in this room. I see Jesus shining through. And so I was working through of going, man, we're thankful for our moms, right? And it's all about them. But there was, I was working through it, man, it's Jesus shining through our moms. And so without Jesus, they're not shining. They're not shining to the potential the way the Lord has made them. And so I want you to see this as we go through that this morning. So I got 4 points here. So point one is similar to the title, Mom Have Superpowers. Because they do, man. I can tell you that I can see from growing up, and it just happens to be that my mom's here today, that I believe that she could fly at times, you know. Because she could catch me when I was a little boy falling. She could just catch me, and I was like, wow, I could fly, and she's flying too, right? So mom have superpowers. Two, moms are intentional. Man, as I see, moms are intentional. Two, what is the title moms, right? Point three is titled, they're a mom, right? And I'm going to explain that. And four, you're a role model. You are a role model. So as we look at point one, that moms have superpowers, as I was reflecting through scripture this week, there were so many, like, getting into the depth of Greek words and different things that moms were given this character of love and support because of Jesus. And we can see that in Jesus, the way his characters were, man, he loved and he was caring for and he was compassionate and he was an affectionate, right? That Jesus was about others. And that's how I see moms. Moms are up early, they're up late, right? They're compassionate and they're an affectionate and they're about others. And moms are a gift. Moms are a gift to our communities and to our families and to those around us and to those in the church. Man, there were so many moms growing up as a wild teenager I was in the church. Man, there were so many moms that became my mom. There were so many moms that took me and brought me up in the church. And so I appreciate that women will stand up and adopt other kids. Women will stand up and bring on, right? They weren't my mom, but they took on the role of mom in my life. Because they expressed that love and discipleship and leadership of taking me on and loving on me, even as a wild teenager. So Titus 2:4 talks that they would admonish young women to love their husbands and to love their children. And where I'm going at here is in Titus, it talks about older women loving on younger women. Men, older women loving on younger women and coming in and ministering and blessing. And I go, man, those are our grandmas. Woo! Like, those are our grandmas. They're moms too, right? But we call them grandmas. And we are so blessed by our grandmas because they come alongside young moms and help them. They come along and they disciple them and they minister to them and they show them. And in this verse it talks about they would admonish them, they would encourage them and push them to love their husbands and their children. Because they're struggling or it's hard. And so that we need the older women to step into this role and to love on young women, right? I mean, we need the church of godly grandmas to come in and love on the young women in our community and in our church and those around us. Why? Because they're super moms. They are. They have so much wisdom and so much wisdom as they grew and they loved their husband and they loved their children. They have some wisdom to share with the younger moms because they fell down and they got back up. They're generations here. As you look in this, in one sense in the scripture, I see three generations of women. You got grandma, you got daughter, and you got granddaughter. Man, it's three generations. Man, grandma has so much wisdom and insight on the next generation. Let me tell you, and moms don't stop, right? I mean, the last time I got sick, my mom told me what I should do. Mom, I am 33. I think I know what to do. Well, let me tell you. Are you drinking your aloe vera water? No, Mom, I'm not drinking any aloe vera water. Well, you better. It would make you feel better. Are you drinking your vinegar? Are you doing it? And I'm like, oh, my goodness. I feel like I'm five all over again. And then you go with a godly response. Yes, Mom. Yes, Mom. Right? So at some part, do we ever really grow up? I'm not sure. But moms care. Moms care and they love and they want to help and they do it. They admonish, not even knowing what some of the scripture says about loving and encouraging and building others up. I mean, it's amazing the gift that as a husband and a son that we get from our wives who are moms and our moms. And as I was processing what Jesus has done for us and how he wraps his arms around us by him dying on the cross for our sins and loving us right where we are, it brought back so many wonderful memories of my mom doing that with me. And how our moms are showing Jesus to us without us even knowing it. Now, being the youngest, I was always beat up on, right? I was the wrecking ball, and so I'd get beat up, and Mom would call me and say, "Get over here, Thomas," right? And I wasn't crying because I'm so manly, right? And so I would come over, and my mom would comfort me. She would comfort me, and her love would calm me. Her love would calm me, and I would have peace. And I would go back out to the world again, right? And the world would beat me back up again, a.k.a. my two older brothers, right? And then there was moments where I thought, man, I remember riding my bike. And I remember crashing my bike and my mom calling me and said, "Let's put a Band-Aid on it," right? Now, the Band-Aid didn't make it feel any better. But my mom's love, wrapping her love around me, made it seem like it was the world, right? Like her fake kissing it, now that I realize as an adult, she was fake kissing it, you know. Oh, it's better, isn't it, already? Oh, yes, Mom, it is. Right? But her love was so genuine and so real that it would calm you. You could be like, "Man, I'm going to go get on a bike and try it again," right? And she would encourage you to get back on it, right? Man, that's what my mom did, and she encouraged me to go back into the world and do it again. And I'm like, man, those are moms. Showing Jesus to those around them. Showing that comfort and that love. And you go, man, moms didn't get that of them of themselves. Man, they got it from God's word and his truth. And so look at me with me with Romans 8. Romans 8 with me. Verse 37. This is where the moms get it. Romans 8:37. "Yet in all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us," Jesus. For I am persuaded that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any created thing shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which in Christ Jesus. Men, as believers, as we set our faith in Jesus Christ and what he has done for us on the cross, men, we are in him. Man, he holds us tight, and that hug, man, nothing's going to get us. And I look at that as a kid falling off my bike and going to mom comforting me, mom holding me, mom supporting me. And you feel like nothing's going to touch you, right? Because nothing's going to touch a mother bear, right, with her baby cub, right? And especially being the youngest, never being spoiled, I'm telling you, never spoiled me. Oh, the other two got spoiled. The baby is never spoiled. I don't know where that comes from. But as I look at this scripture, I go, this is where moms get it from. They get it from the characteristic of Jesus' love. That Jesus wraps his arms around us and gives us the strength to go back out into the world and to live for Jesus. That it's his love. Nothing can separate us from him. Man, what a truth that we need to set in and to memorize and to lean into, that Jesus has us close. That Jesus has us close, and what our moms do for us is amazing. You know, I look back in so many times and go, is mom just doing her job? No, mom loves and she cares and she supports because she loves me. Not because I was her favorite son, right? You know, I still believe that whether she believes it or not. But Jesus holds us close because he cares for us. He protects us from Satan. He's watching out for us. He has our best interest in mind. He's comforting us. I don't know about y'all, but I need that from Jesus. And how special it is that we get to experience that here on earth through our godly women. And how profound that is. Man, we need that. Man, we need that. Wow. Man, the love from our parents make a big deal. And that makes it hard in this season as some of us miss our moms. Because our moms did just that. They held things together. They encouraged. They blessed. They were the ones that you can go and have a talk with and have a conversation with. And from this passage you can see, man, they protected us. And they encouraged us. And they built us up to go at it again. And that's why many of us have a hard time with Mother's Day. Because it's hard. Because we miss our moms. Because our moms were so vital in showing us Jesus. Our moms were so vital in the way they lived for Jesus. And the way they shined for Jesus. And the way that our moms gave us hugs. The physical hugs that we get. And then we see we get the spiritual as we get into God's Word. And we see what Jesus does for us. And I'm not trying to steal mom's thunder, but I just love how Jesus comes into our lives and ministers to us right where we're at. Like our moms do for us. Man, Jesus is doing that for us spiritually, so it's profound. Jesus doesn't take a break. He doesn't get a day off. He doesn't get sick days, right? And I go, man, that sounds like our moms. They don't get sick days. They don't get a day off. Especially when they need it, right? Man, that's our moms. As I was working through this, man, I watched some videos of interviews. And they did live interviews of this guy interviewing different people. And he was describing the job of a mom. And every one of them goes, why would I ever do that, right? That's a joke. Like, I get no benefits, I don't get paid, I don't get time off, I have to work 24 hours on my feet while holding a baby and multitasking, right? Like, what kind of job are you talking about? And he goes, that's a mom. And by the end, they all started laughing, like, wow, moms really do that much for us. Man, it's profound. Man, Jesus is above that. Man, he knows what we need spiritually, and he's in our corner, and he's supporting us, and he's there to listen to us. How thankful I am for both. Man, moms are intentional. Out of Deuteronomy 6, and these words which I command you today shall be in your heart, that you shall teach them diligently to your children, and you shall talk of them when you sit in your house, and when you walk by the way, and when you lie down, and when you rise up. Man, moms are intentional. Moms are constantly intentional in the way they love their children and minister to their children, whether it's at bedtime. Hey, mom, will you pray with me real quick before I go to bed, right? My kids are constantly wanting one more moment with mom. And mom takes that moment of being intentional, and she says, I would love to pray with you. Man, they're intentional. When are they not intentional? Man, moms are so intentional of sharing God's love and his goodness, even as an adult, right? My own mother is very intentional in the way she texts me and says, I'm praying for you. They're intentional. And God's word tells us that moms are intentional. Parents are intentional along the way. They're constantly ministering and loving and looking for opportunities to be intentional. I know in our house, there is always opportunities for examples, right? Because kids give you free examples all the time, right? Whether they're jumping off the couch or doing something crazy or not sharing, there are many opportunities of being intentional because kids are giving you examples of what not to do or being great examples of what to do. I remember this week, one literally said, I'm going to share today, and was sharing everything. And I was like, here's a good example. So we paused and we did a little lesson on it, right? Because it was like it was a perfect opportunity of what was being done well. So we took that moment to be intentional and to minister right where we are. I mean, moms are so intentional. The title, Moms. Psalms 127, verse 3, Behold, children are a heritage from the Lord. And I wanted to talk to our moms here that are, whether you're a stepmom or you adopted kids or you're a grandma or you're a grandma who has adopted some kids, man, your title mom is profound. Because I've heard women who say, well, I don't have any kids. But then you stop and you look and they're ministering, they're teaching Sunday school, they're loving on kids, they've adopted kids, they're ministering to kids. I know school teachers that are moms that have no kids, that they're more moms than some of the moms out there. Because they're loving and they're ministering and they're showing stewardship. Man, you are a steward, ladies, of the children that are around you. Whether it's your grandkids or whether it's a kid you have adopted, they don't have to be your blood for you to be a mom to them. Man, you get to minister and you get to bless and you get to steward because children are a heritage from the Lord. And how amazing it is as this church supports the pregnancy center, man, you get to be a part of stewarding because we believe that children are heritage from the Lord. You get to be a part of that. You get to encourage that. You get to spur on that. Because how we need more women to step up and minister to kids that are struggling. Kids that are being raised in broken homes. Kids that are struggling that maybe their mom is gone and they need another mom to step in and minister to bless. Maybe it's your grandkids are struggling. You get to come in and minister to your grandkids. Man, your title, mom or grandma, is huge. It's huge and it's profound if you will live that out because there are so many kids who need someone to come alongside them and show them that godly hug and remind them that Jesus cares about them and loves them because there are so many kids that are struggling in defeat because they're experiencing the hardships of this world. I mean, it's constantly that one of my kids are coming home from school experiencing all the time. They're experiencing it. They're saying, Dad, it's not fair. It's not fair. And I'm going, man, love them because that's what they need. They need that love. And so I want to encourage you moms this morning and grandmas and those who say you're not a mom, and adopt some kids and show them Jesus. Show them Jesus because they need a woman to come in and minister to them and show them the love of Christ. Remind them of the hope and the joy and the peace that we have in Jesus Christ. Stand in the gap for them. Stand in the gap for them. Maybe there's a kid in this community, right? There was Mary Brown was vital in picking kids up on the golf cart and taking them up and being mom. She picked them up and loved on them, gave them popsicles, gave them Bibles, right? You know, I heard this week, James is still having to buy popsicles and keep them in the fridge because they're still stopping by. Because of the legacy that Mary Brown started with having popsicles at her house. And so James has to keep a whole fridge full, right? Because they keep stopping by. Wanting to be encouraged and wanting to be blessed. Man, those are the power and the opportunities that we have to minister to the kids in this community. Just because you don't have that title doesn't mean that you can't be a light and a blessing to the kids around you. You know, it's profound to be a light in the darkness for Jesus. To stand in the gap for these kids that are struggling in this community. Maybe it's your grandkids. Man, grandma, stand in the gap for them. Stand in the gap and go to the Lord in prayer and lean into Him. And ask Him to show up in these kids' lives and minister, because it's huge. I know some of y'all are still raising your grandkids. And they're not kids anymore, right? They're big kids now. So stand in the gaps, because I know the grandmas are already doing that. I know it. I know the grandmas are already doing that. Because I know many of you already in here that you have came to me and asked for prayer because you are standing in the gaps for your grandkids because you love them. You're being mom, right? Steve, will you show us that clip real quick?
You've done it again, Lord. You've done it again. You are good and you are mighty and you are merciful. And you keep taking care of me when I don't deserve it. Praise you, Jesus. You are Lord. Give me another one, Lord. Guide me to who you want me to help. Raise up more that will call upon your name. Raise up those that love you and seek you and trust you. Raise them up, Lord. Raise them up. Lord, we need a generation of believers who are not ashamed of the gospel. We need an army of believers, Lord. Hate to be lukewarm and will stand on your word above all else. Raise them up, Lord. Raise them up. I pray for unity among those that love you. I pray that you open their eyes so that they can see your truth, Lord. I pray for your hand of protection and guidance. Raise up a generation, Lord, that will take light into this world. that will not compromise when under pressure, that will not cower, Lord, when others fall away. Raise them up, Lord, that they will proclaim that there is salvation in the name of Jesus Christ. Raise up warriors, Lord, who will fight on their knees, who will worship you with their whole hearts, Lord. Lord, call us to battle, that we may proclaim you King of Kings and Lord of Lords. I pray these things with all my heart. Raise them up, Lord, raise them up.
Y'all, I wanted just to give you an example of what that would look like as we pray, as our moms pray for the next generation, as they pray for their grandkids, as they pray for their community. Man, I love this example of this grandma praying for the next generation. And I know that's true for many of our grandmas in here already doing that, praying for their kids and their grandkids, and standing in the gap. And so I want to encourage you to stand in the gap. And I know many of you are already doing that. Many of you are already standing in the gap for that next generation. And so I want to encourage you to be a role model in that. Be a role model in that, because of how many of our kids and our grandkids are watching how grandma acts and how grandma is and what grandma's doing and how mom is doing and how mom is acting. Man, you are such a role model because they're watching. The community is watching and how you react and how you live out your faith for Jesus Christ. Man, be a role model by the way you live your life. Be a role model in the way you love others and how you minister to people. Man, be in the Word, be in prayer, living out God's goodness and His grace, and stand in the gap for these kids. For your kids, for your grandkids, for those around you, because we need more godly women to stand in the gap for that. And again, I can't emphasize enough that you don't have to have that title mom to be a light in the darkness. Because there were so many times in my faith that women in the church came alongside of me and took me in and ministered to me when I was struggling and took on that role of mom in my life. Man, I could give you a whole list of name of women who did that for me, who stood in the gaps for me spiritually and ministered to me and told me the hard things and loved on me. Man, stand in the gap and be a model for those around you. Man, live for Jesus, because moms have such a unique role and the way they live out their faith. Man, the way they live for Jesus, how they minister to kids and how they minister to their kids is constant. They don't get a day off. They're constantly loving on their families day in and day out. Whether they're adolescents or they're teenagers or they're young adults. Man, they're living that role model constantly. And so I want to encourage you to keep constantly living out your faith in Jesus Christ and living for Him, for Jesus to use you and for you to be aware of when you can stand in the gaps. Because if you're not tuned into His Word and you're not walking with the Holy Spirit, you're going to miss some of those opportunities. And so I want to encourage you to be in the Word and to be in prayer and to lifting up those around you. Being those moms that are coming around and encouraging like my mom did and putting a Band-Aid and maybe even praying with me and loving on me and hugging me and showing me Jesus through compassion. Man, we can do that right here in this community. Man, it's everywhere. I see it weekly of how we can live for Jesus in this community. And so I want to encourage you to keep doing that. Keep living out your faith boldly for Jesus Christ. So let me pray in closing. Dear Lord, I thank you so much for your love on the cross. Lord, that you give us the example of what it looks like to show love and compassion. Lord, I know sometimes as men we look at love and compassion as weak. But Lord, you are so loving and compassionate to those who need it most. Lord, I'm thankful for moms who are loving and compassionate. They're not weak, but they're real and sincere. Lord, I thank you for the way you have made women. You've made them in your image. Lord, they are image bearers of Jesus Christ. So Lord, I just lift up our women today that they would be image bearers in our communities. Lord, I pray for the grandmas and the moms in this room that are going to leave here today and they're going to reach out to their kids. Because their kids are struggling with life, they're struggling with sin, they're struggling with their walk with you, Lord. I pray that you would give them the words today to love on them. That you would give these moms and these grandmas, Lord, your word to share with them and that their kids would receive your word. Lord, we thank you for that. Lord, we thank you for your word that empowers us to go forth. That I know many of the grandmas in this room, they're empowered by your word because of their relationship with Jesus, Lord. Lord, we thank you for that. Lord, we thank you for your love and your grace that you have showed us on the cross, that you have modeled to us how to live our life in the image of you, Lord. Amen. Steve, will you play the last song, please, in closing?